Magandang araw muli mga kapwa OFW, lalong-lalo na yung mga OFW sa bansang Oman. This is Juan Inoman once again. So today, ano po, the OWA launched its latest educational assistance offering to qualified children of its member OFWs affected by the COVID-19 pandemic through its Project EASE. So ano nga ba yung Project EASE for the educational assistance through scholarship in emergencies? This aims to provide educational assistance to qualified college-level dependents of active OWA member OFWs whose employment were affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. The project aims to provide educational assistance of 10,000 per annum for a maximum of 4 years. So, anyway, bago tayo mapunta sa napaka-detalyadong information ng Project EASE, roll intro muna. So, ayan. Tingnan natin kung ano nga ba yung educational assistance through scholarship in emergencies o kaya tinatawag ng OWA na Project EASE. Project EASE is a component of the care program for OFWs affected by the COVID-19 pandemic that provides educational assistance of 10,000 per annum for a maximum of 4 years in the college level to qualified dependent of active OWA OFW members. So, ito po, ano? Yan, napakaliwanag po. 10,000 per annum. Maximum of 4 years in the college level. Saka, so para sa mga active OWA OFW members. So, sino nga ba yung mga qualified para sa Project EASE? Project EASE covers qualified dependent of active OFW member, land-based, sea-based, balik manggagawa. At the time of their repatriation to the country from the declaration of the outbreak on February 1, 2020 hanggang sa ideklara ng WHO or kaya any competent authority na controlled na yung pandemic. So, who are eligible? Eligible dependent of OWA member OFWs refers to anak ng may asawang OFW or single parent OFW o kaya kapatid ng single na OFW. Yan, pwede yung kapatid ninyo kung ikaw ay single. Ang hindi covered po ay yung may mga existing scholarship grant under ODESP, EDSP at ELAP. Of course, hindi rin covered dyan yung inactive OWA members. At saka yung undocumented workers. So, maliwanag po, dapat active OFW members. Yan yung pinaka-importanteng qualification para makapag-apply. So, what are the requirements? Of course, number one requirement is accomplish application for Project EASE na nasa ease.owa.gov.ph. Pwede nyo po yan fill up online or pwede nyo download yung form na nasa owa.gov.ph. Forms is.pdf. Then number 2, submit to OWA Regional Welfare Office email indicated copies of the following. So, copy ng valid passport, flight ticket, official receipt ng OWA membership, proof of relationship to the OFW, pwede dyan yung birth certificate, SENOMAR, yan. Certificate of grade of the dependent. So, paano mag-apply? Qualified active OWA member OFWs who returned to the country from February 1, 2020 onward shall file the application to their designated child beneficiary at online platform is.owa.gov.ph and submit all the required documents through OWA Regional Welfare Office email. So, yan, i-email nyo po doon. The applicant shall receive a serial reference tracking number via SMS or email for monitoring of the status application. Applicants who submitted incomplete or invalid requirement shall be notified via SMS or email of the lacking invalidated requirements. Approved application shall be issued a downloadable and printable scholarship agreement online for signature and notarization. Signed and notarized scholarship agreements are sent back via any courier services to the concerned RWO. Qualified beneficiaries of the Project East will be announced and payment of the assistance shall be through bank remittance direct to the bank account of student beneficiary. Ayan po ano, malinaw po yan. So, important reminders. OFW couples who are both eligible for the program shall be entitled to only one slot. So, kung mag-asawa kayong OFW, isang slot lang po ang available para sa inyo. So, isang anak lang ang pwede ninyong i-apply. Availment of this program shall not be deterrent in applying for OFW dependent scholarship program and yung EDSP. Qualified beneficiaries of the Project East must have an active account number in their name to receive the remittance annually. So, ayan, dapat yung anak ninyo meron siyang account, bank account. Ano po? So, anyway, kung gusto nyong gumawa ng bank account, ayan, check nyo lamang po yan kung paano gumawa sa OF Bank, Overseas Filipino Bank. So, yun lamang po ano, para sa mga karagdagang information, bumisita lamang po kayo sa owa.com.ph. Nandun po lahat ng mga information na kailangan ninyo. And kung may katanungan po kayo, we will try to answer them. Pag may comment po kayo, babasahin namin. Kung bago lang kayo sa aking channel, pakiclick naman yung subscribe button at saka yung notification bell para makita ninyo kung mayroon tayong mga bagong video na ilalabas. Maraming salamat sa panonood. Click the like button and share this video. Maraming salamat po. God bless everyone. Keep safe.